Stay warm.
Right, Aki Kareem, British Boxing Television. I'm over here at the Fox ABC in Failsworth. Delighted to be joined by former WBA champion of the world, Anthony Million Dollar Crawler. Thanks for having us down here today, mate.
Thanks for coming down, mate. Always good to have you.
It's always good to see you, and we'll talk to the lads later. You've got a good little stable here emerging. You were straight out of boxing and straight into training.
Yes, it was always sort of planned just to have a bit of time out, spend a bit of time with the amateurs, but it's not worked like that. I've been spending the time with the amateurs, but before looking at working with any professionals, then it started with Dylan. Then Jake came along, and now Macaulay. Macaulay McGowan, the last few weeks, been working with Macaulay. So yeah, the stable's growing. There's another lad at the minute who's just got to wait and see a few medical things. But yeah, so at the minute, we've got the three of them in. So I'm enjoying it with them. So I'm in this place so much. Then obviously, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, when I can, I'm in with the amateur lads as well, helping the coaching team at the Fox. So yeah, I'm in the gym more than ever. And obviously, yeah, I nearly forgot. So on Monday, Wednesday, Friday, I've been at with Joe, with the lads, helping prepare them for their big fights, sort of things, sort of being a bit of an assistant to Joe, really. So I feel like I'm learning great things there, working alongside some top fighters, and I think that'll only help me. You'll become a better coach.
Absolutely. Now, at one stage, you were saying you didn't want to take any more fighters on, but you know, I know what you're like. You've got a big heart, haven't you? But also, you just love the game, don't you?
Yeah, so? Of course I do, and boxing, I said it all along, it's always going to be a huge part of my life. But you know, these lads, and I see them, and I've knew all three lads for a number of time, and I genuinely mean this here. I just want to help them get the best out of what they've got, and if I do that, I believe they can do well. I think, you know, we see Macaulay, who's just joined, he's had a sort of very stop-start career. It's around 14, 15 fights, but over a long time, but because he's had that amount of fights, I almost feel like I'm starting again with him, so I wish I was. Not a four-round level, but six, then build into it, but I'm probably not going to get that with him. I'm probably going to get a fight or two, you know, a few fights, and then he's going to be in a real fight, but he's talented, and I just want to get him sort of, it's not that he doesn't live the life at all, but he's, you know, he's had a lot of things he's had to sort out first at home, a lot of priorities, and he's done that, but he's a lad who I believe's got a lot of talent, and I believe if I get the best out of what he's got, I think he does very well in the sport. Obviously, Dylan is a lad I've been working from the start. I know he had the fight with Steve Mailer, who, you know, done very well with him. You know, he added a lot to Dylan's game. So again, it's just me trying to add things to Dylan's game, and you know, having boxing sort of to his strengths. And what Dylan is, he's not got the amateur pedigree of Macaulay or Jake, but what he has got is someone he'll give you absolutely everything he's got. Absolutely everything he's got, and that's why I know he'll get the best out of what he has. And he's an handful, and he's improving. I'm really liking the way he's coming on. He's just been unlucky with injuries, and but he's injury free now, so we're looking at getting out hopefully in April time. And just what sort of getting boxing regular now. It's like it's not been for any fault of his own, and that's it. Now he's in the gym, about getting fit. He's out the fridge. He likes his food like a lot of boxers, but he's improving. I really like the way he's coming on. And then obviously finally Jake, he's just been, we're talking about injuries, an old injury that he's had for the past 12 months, came up sort of after the last fight, and he's had to have an hand up, and really important that he did have it. And Mike Hayton, possibly, like you hear so many times, you know, through boxers, especially in this area, possibly saved his career. He says, you know, if you would have had another fight with that, it could have been, if it would have gone again, it could have been career threatening. But it was just massive disappointment, because Jake was in the new series of the Contender VIP at light welter, and the way he was coming on, I really believed he had a great chance of winning that. He was in with, you know, three good lads.
Yeah.
Lads who respect and lads who I know all of them. But I believe Jake, again, he's very talented, and his chance will come again for stuff like that. His chance will come again for stuff like that. But he's had the op just the other day, and his recovery, the expectation time for him to be punching again has been cut in half. So that's great news for him. You know, he was down. I was down as a trainer, because I was probably, there's times I was meant to be like, Jake, you know, don't worry about it. Well, I was gutted. I was, you know, I was absolutely sick because I thought, oh, I was really looking forward to this tournament that was been put together. We've seen it's a great little concept, threw some great fights together. The one just before Christmas where Diego Costa burst onto the scene, winning that. So I was gutted. I was gutted for him, but, and he was. But now that's been cut in half. Obviously, he's going to be back in the ring soon. We can't rush it, but it's obviously he's here today. He's not punching because he's not allowed to get anything sweater. So he says, but no, I know that because a few of the lads at Gallagher's gym have had the same up for a few days, but he's in here and I've just got Dylan and McCauley in today. They've got a bit of a light session today.
Yeah, yeah. Well, a lot of people are going to have their eye on you because the transition from boxer to trainer, sometimes it goes brilliantly, sometimes it's not as successful.
Of course, yeah.
What's your sort of ethos as a trainer? Because are you going to be looking at the lads, I mean, and knowing the lads, they've got different styles to you.
Of course they have, yeah.
Yeah, and how are you going to balance that out?
That's it. I never ever want to try and have the lads, any of the lads, try and turn them into a copy of me. I think Dylan's got similarities to me and what I had, so hopefully the strengths that I had I can put into Dylan, but the things that I did wrong, I don't want Dylan doing them as well. Whereas McCauley is very different to what I was, and Jake is. So I want them all boxing their own way, sort of to the best, you know, boxing to their strengths, and I think that's what a good trainer does. You know, he gets the best out of each and every one of their lads in their own way. You can't train each and every lad the same, you know, they respond to different things.
Mm. Well, you were obviously immensely successful in your boxing career, reaching that summit of the world title, WBA world title in Manchester when you beat Dali,
yep.
Perez. You know, you've been successful in your media career as well, got, you know, doing all the stuff everywhere. We see you on
TV
everywhere.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm enjoying it.
But, you know, how important is it for you then to be to make a success at the training side of things?
Massively important. I think anything I want to do in life, I want to make it a success, and whether it be with these or whether it be with the amateur lads, I just want to get the best out of them. It's not about trying to earn money off these lads, because I won't take a thing off them, because there's not any boxing there's very few boxing trainers who make a living out of being a boxing trainer.
Yeah.
At this,
yeah.
And especially at this level when they're in four rounders, six rounders, you know, there's not. So I'm doing it to get the best out of them, and that's what I want to do. I believe, you know, me as a fighter, I got the best out of what I had, and see some of these lads certainly more talented than what I was, so they can get the best out of what they've got, a bit of luck, which you need in all careers, then I believe they can do well.
I wish you the very best luck with
Thank
the training
you, okay.
element.
Good lad, don't just do it. Good lad, right hand, yeah? Go, yeah? Jump. And stand up to the ball. Good shot. Roll out. Good, yeah?
There's a massive
yes,
fight coming up this weekend.
There is.
Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury for, well, the lineage at stake, also the WBC
yes,
belts at stake. It's an intriguing fight. A lot
yeah,
of people are split on this one. How do you see the fight going?
Yeah, it's so tough to call. I mean, I'll be honest, the first time, as much as I wanted Tyson to do it, the first time I just thought, the layoff, everything like that, I can't see it, but he shocked the world and he didn't get the decision, but he won that fight. Everyone knows that. And I think going off that first fight, it's hard not to make Tyson a favourite again. However, since that fight, you know, and the form since, I've always been a believer Tyson needs that opponent, that fear factor to get the best out of him. And I think Tyson on Saturday, he wins on points, but it sounds like, oh, but we all know the power that Deontay Wilder carries. I'm not speaking out of turn. He's one of the biggest punchers we've seen in recent years in boxing. Just crazy power, that kind of power that ends fights in an instance. And that's why I think when people are going on saying do you know the cut that Tyson had last time? Do you think that comes into play? And I said no for the simple fact if Deontay Wilder's hitting you enough for that to come in, he's putting you over and out.
Yeah.
But for me, the best case scenario, and I won't be surprised if that happens, would be the best case scenario is the first two or three rounds, Tyson gets clipped and only clipped, and he might touch down or he might be hurt, and that makes him super cautious where, you know, he just looks to touch, to poke. He doesn't, listen, all the talk about a knockout, I'd be shocked if he goes for that, as everyone else will. But I think he might take a shot like where he feels and he thinks, you know, I've got to be on it. I've got to be on everything. I've got to be super switched on. Because if he is, I believe a boxing ability, boxing IQ, he's levels above Deontay Wilder, as was Luis Ortiz, who for me, technically probably the best heavyweight on the planet. I know we talk about his age and we don't know really whether he's 48 or 58 or we don't know how old he really is.
Yeah.
So, but for me, technically, like an unbelievably gifted, do you know what I mean, for an heavyweight.
Yeah, of course.
He was beating Wilder for every second, every minute of every round going into that, and then Wilder landed that shot.
Just a short little shot as well.
And it hit, you know, you felt the ring shudder, didn't you?
Yeah.
And so that's sort of what makes this fight so interesting, you know, when you've got the boxing skills of Tyson Fury versus the power of Deontay Wilder. You just don't know what's going to happen. You really don't. And Tyson can't switch off for 1 second or 1 minute of a round in the fight. If he doesn't do that, I believe we see a Tyson Fury win on points, and I think he wins pretty convincing.
All right, there you go. We've got Tyson Fury on points, but it's going to be an exciting one.
It will be an exciting one. Whether it'll have the thrills and spills of the first fight, well, I don't believe we'll ever see anything like what we did in the 12th round last time. But I think there's going to be excitement because we're always going to be on edge. Is it going to happen again or not? We'll see. But Tyson Fury points.
All right, Anthony, really appreciate your time.
Aki, thanks for having us.
Got stuff to do, but
we'll get these going.
Cheers, mate. Appreciate it.
Thank you, mate. Nice one.